Welcome back to another video with It's Dr. Dan, and we're going to be looking at dehydration reactions, which are a type of elimination reaction of alkanes to make an alkene. Now, what is dehydration? Well, think of hydration, right? Hydration is adding water to your body. Well, in this case, dehydrate is removing water. So how are we going to make water? Well, if you saw the addition reaction video, that was also posted recently. Water is all has an OH and H component that are on a chain. So what we're going to be looking for is looking for an OH attached to a carbon, and then we're going to be moving a hydrogen from an adjacent carbon. Now, when those are both removed, we're going to make H2O as a product, and as a result, it's going to make a double bond to adjust for the fact that we don't have all of our bonds remaining. So we will have that CH2 on one carbon, and then we will add our hydrogens to the other. So this goes from an alkane to an alkene through this elimination process. So you can also see that it goes from one reactant to two products. So it's the opposite of what we saw with addition. Now with this, you'll commonly also see that it has an acid catalyst in the reaction as well. So it could be an acid, it could be heat. It's something that's showing that we're having a breaking down of our different components. Let's look at some more in-depth reactions. The one really common problem that you're given is form the major product from the dehydration reaction. And when you're looking at this, you're like, oh man, what exactly do I have to do? So when we have this general reaction, what we can see is we are always given some kind of reactant. And what we're going to be doing is identifying the major components that we're going to be ripping off. And one thing you can remember, well, our goal is to form water. So we're going to be taking away an OH. Now, the question is, where do we remove the hydrogen from? Because you could remove it from the carbon on its left or the carbon on its right. So if we were to fill in all those hydrogens, we have 1, 2, 3 on the right-hand side and then 1, 2 on the left. Where do we choose? It's kind of a little bit of a dilemma that we have is like, okay, do I pick one from over here or do I pick one on the left-hand side? So let's write down both those products. And what we are going to do is go through another rule to be able to define what we will have. So it's the same idea. We copy down our carbon structure and we are going to write that backbone down because the carbons stay the same. We're only removing the alcohol. So the one that I have here on the upper side here, this is if I remove the hydrogen that is in orange. So if we remove that one, it's going to make the double bond on the end of the chain. And if we remove the hydrogen from the one in red, it will make the double bond in the middle of the chain. So you can see how there is a big difference in both of these, right? We have pentene on the top. And over here, we have 2-pentene, which will also have cis and trans isomers to it. So there's a big difference between the two. Which one will we have? Let's look at our rule to determine which is the correct answer. Seth rule, which goes through a lot of scientific verbiage for how to describe which hydrogen you are going to pluck off of this alkene chain. The easy way to remember it is think of predator versus prey mentality. How exactly are you going to look at these structures? So with this, it's all about removing the hydrogen that is more by itself. You want to go for the weakest link in your parent or your chain. So you want to find the one that's by itself. So let's take a look at the example we were doing before. Let's see if we can see which hydrogen is an easier target to remove from our chain. So in this example, we had two separate chains that we formed. Now, how do we tell which one is the lower of the two? Well, what we're going to do is we're going to look back on our original structure. And if you can see on the left-hand side, I have two hydrogens. And on the right-hand side, I have three. So the whole idea here is that we want to pick the structure that involves the least amount of work. Which one is by itself? Which in this case, you can see that the reddish structure would have only two. So that is going to be easier to pluck off and to remove. So our correct answer for our major product is going to be the bottom species. Now, keep in mind, when you say major, that does not mean it's the only product. It just tells you that it could be 60%, 70%, 80% of that major product or more, sometimes even as high as 100. But it all depends on the conditions of your reaction and what you were doing in lab. So 2-pentene would be our choice. Let's go on to one other example. So once again, if I asked you to form the major product from a dehydration reaction, and I gave you a 1-methyl cyclohexanol as an example, what we are going to do as before, we are going to first identify where we are going to remove an OH. Now, the next component is, well, where exactly do we remove a hydrogen from? Because it's going to be one of the adjacent carbons next to our starred carbon here. So if we are to star that, it could be multiple locations. So let's highlight them to show. So we have one that is in this teal blue. We have one that could be in orange, and then one that can be in red. You have multiple options that are available. So let's take a look at this particular structure. And let's go through all those options. Where exactly would it make sense to remove? So if we are to analyze that, let's draw that a little bit bigger, and we will write our OH. Now, when we are looking at that, how many do we have on, let's say, the red carbon up here? How many hydrogens do you see? Well, there's already currently two bonds there. So there is going to be two hydrogens on this particular structure. So we have a H here and an H here. On the orange structure, on the orange carbon, it's going to be the same general deal, right? We have two hydrogens on each part. And then on our last one, which was, I believe, the teal blue one, we have three hydrogens for each part, right? So we have 1, 2, 3. Now the question is, where would you remove it from? Well, it's either going to be the top or the bottom. They're both equally possible. Let's draw them both and see which one makes more sense. And let's see if there's even a difference between them as well. So when we go through that, we will have our first structure. I realize I could actually draw a hexagon with this. So we will write our first structure just like so. And we are going to make a double bond on the structure just like this. With our other one, we are going to do the exact same thing. We will fill in our OH and write the double bond like so. Now, judging from those two structures, is there a difference between them or are they the same? When you are checking these, number your priority. So we would start from 1, 2, and then go around that chain, right? 3, 4, 5, 6. It's going to be the same exact cyclic structure on both. It's just flipped from the other one. So they are the same. So either one is your major product here. And if you want to, you could draw your minor product as well. Typically in most introductory classes, you're never asked to draw a minor product, but just in case you are curious about it, we could write that as well, where in this case, you're going to have the double bond on the methyl group with an OH. So this is minor, okay? This would probably be less than 20% at most, whereas the one in green is your major product for this, which would be the answer on any exam or homework and should be accepted. It all depends on your professor or your teacher. So depending on who is teaching your class, definitely make sure you watch and try to understand that. So practice it. Hopefully this video helped you in understanding the Zaitsev rule. Remember, it's all about predator versus prey mentality. We want to remove the hydrogen from the one with least hydrogens, which is what we were doing on this structure. We were counting our hydrogens, removing the one from the least to make our double bond. Please hit that like and subscribe button. I hope to see you for future videos, and thank you so much for stopping by. Bye now.